This is an hour QuadCities.com update.
Good morning, it's 8:55. Thanks for watching. I'm Brittany Dobbins with your hour QuadCities.com update. One person was killed in a crash in Scott County Thursday night. The person who died was the 18-year-old driver of one of the cars involved. Investigators say that driver crossed the center line in a small truck on Utica Ridge Road, hitting a minivan near 210th Street. A car behind the minivan then hit it from behind. The minivan driver was taken to the hospital with serious injuries. The other driver involved was not seriously hurt. The Scott County Sheriff's Office has not released the names of the people involved in the crash. One of the two Fairfield teenagers who murdered their Spanish teacher will spend the rest of his life behind bars. Willard Miller was sentenced for killing Nohima Graber. He'll be eligible for parole after 35 years. A Fairfield police officer took the stand and shared a possible motive in the case.
He did a passing Spanish grade in order to get his study abroad program that he wanted. He said that he was angry, didn't like how Miss Graber taught the class, and that one day he hoped that she would be dead.
The second teen, Jeremy Goodale, is asking for his sentencing date to be pushed back. Attorneys say that a psychologist for the defense is not available for the current August date. A judge will rule on Goodale's request later this month. Calls for a deeper investigation into USP Thompson come as a new report claims violent and racist treatment of inmates. A team from the Marshall Project, National Public Radio, and the Washington Lawyers Committee for Civil Rights and Urban Affairs put the report together. Some claims of poor prison conditions and mistreatment include inmates in shackles being beaten by guards, a lack of access to mental health care, as well as the deaths of five men in the unit. Homicide is suspected in all of them, and there are a lot more details in this report, and we have those for you at ourquadcities.com. The American Queen Voyage will dock at the Isle Casino this morning. Visit Quad Cities kicked off their National River Cruise season on June 25th after the American Symphony docked at River Heritage Park in Davenport. The Bureau says the Quad Cities will welcome thousands of passengers this year, showcasing the Mississippi River. And Dave Harrell, president and CEO of Visit Quad Cities, says that's good for the area. That's a look at your local news. Now here's Tyler with your local Pinpoint forecast.
Thank you, Brittany. Good morning, everybody. Temperatures right now in the lower 70s across the QCA. Winds coming out of the east around 5 miles per hour. Beautiful start to the day. Starting seeing those temperatures on the rise across the QCA. Could not ask for a better start to your Friday. Now, later on this afternoon, we're going to continue to climb temperature-wise, but clouds will move on in probably here in the next couple of hours. That's going to, of course, slow down that daytime heating. On top of that, there's a slight chance for a shower or two later on this afternoon. So right now, temperatures mid-60s in Galena, 67, Maquoketa, 70, Iowa City, 68 in Des Moines, 66 down in Fairfield. Here's a look at where the radar is right now, or I should say the rain on the radar is. And you can see it's off to the west, crossing the border from Nebraska into Iowa. Got a couple of thunderstorms embedded with that line, but still got a ways to go before that reaches us. But there is that chance for an isolated shower around 4, 5, 6 o'clock tonight. Overnight, some storms possible, could get woken up to some thunder. And then tomorrow, maybe a couple showers around during the morning hours. Clear things out Saturday. Perfect end to JDC on Sunday.
All right. Thanks, Tyler. And thanks for watching. Good Friday morning.